out of this town, drive out of the city, away from the crowds. I thought heaven can't help me now, nothing lasts forever.
Dinosaur on fire.
Cold?
I said no one has to know what we do. His hands are in my hair, his clothes are in my room, and his voice is a familiar sound. Nothing lasts forever.
stop and play its final beat. But it's alright. Easy for you to say.
Thank you. Forever could never be long enough for me to feel like I've had long enough with you. Forget the world now, we won't let them see. But there's one thing left to do. Now that the weight has lifted, love has surely shifted my way. Marry me today and every day. Marry me. If I ever get the nerve to say hello in this cafe, say you will. Say you will. Together could never be close enough for me to feel like I am close enough to you. You wear white and I wear out the words I love you, and you're beautiful. Now that the wait is over, love has finally showed her my way. Marry me today and every day. Marry me. If I ever get the nerve to say hello in this cafe, say you will. Say you will. Promise me you'll always be happy by my side. I promise to sing to you when all the music dies. Thank you.
got a soapbox I can stand upon. But God gave me a stage, a guitar, and a song. My daddy told me, son, don't you get involved in politics, religions, other people's quotes. I'll paint the picture, let me set the scene. I know when I have children, they will know what it means. And I'll pass on the things my family's given to me. Just love and understanding, positivity. We could change this whole world with a piano. Add a bass, some guitar, grab a beat, and away we go. I'm just a boy with a one-man show. No university, no degree, but Lord knows everybody's talking about exponential growth and the stock market crashing in their portfolios. While I'll be sitting here with a song that I wrote, saying love could change the world in a moment. But what do I know? Love can change the world in a moment. But what do I know? Love can change the world in a moment. The revolution's coming, it's a minute away. I saw people marching in the streets today. You know we are made up of love and hate, but both of them are balanced on a razor blade. I'll paint the picture, let me set the scene. I know I'm all for people following their dreams. Just remember life is more than fitting in your jeans. It's love and understanding, positivity. We could change this whole world with a piano. Add a bass, some guitar, grab a beat, and away we go. I'm just a boy with a one-man show. No university, no degree, but Lord knows everybody's talking about exponential growth and the stock market crashing in their portfolios. While I'll be sitting here with a song that I wrote, saying love could change the world in a moment. But what do I know? Love can change the world in a moment. But what do I know? Love can change the world in a moment. I'll paint the picture, let me set the scene. You know the future's in the hands of you and me. So let's all get together, we can all be free. Spread love and understanding, positivity. We could change this whole world with a piano. Add a bass, some guitar, grab a beat, and away we go. I'm just a boy with a one-man show. No university, no degree, but Lord knows everybody's talking about exponential growth and the stock market crashing in their portfolios. While I'll be sitting here with a song that I wrote, saying love could change the world in a moment. But what do I know? Love can change the world in a moment. But what do I know? Love can change the world in a moment. But what do I know?
This is the moment you've waited for. You've been searching in the dark, your sweat soaking through the floor. And buried in your bones, there's an ache that you can't ignore. Taking your breath, stealing your mind, and all that was real is left behind. Don't fight it, it's coming for you, running at you. It's only this moment, don't care what can gather. Your fever dream, can't you see you getting closer? Just surrender, cause you feel the feeling taking over. It's fire, it's freedom, it's flooding open. It's a preacher in the pulpit and your blind devotion. There's something breaking at the brick of every wall, it's holding on.
Used to this. so certain. And I finally found what I'd been missing. It's this, it's this.
We're here gathered again to celebrate the wedding of one of my daughters. So, on behalf of Rachel and Stuart, Stuart's parents, Steve and Debbie, and me and Karen, we'd like to welcome you all here at the Treehouse in this rather unique location to celebrate the marriage of our youngest princess Rachel and her new prince Stuart. And doesn't the bride look beautiful? So when Rachel told me she was getting married in a treehouse, I must admit, I envisioned something a bit different to this. I thought, great, a small wedding, about 8 guests, put a couple of pallets per tree, new leather, a bit of ribbons running the rungs, was sorted. How wrong I was. So, as I do up here this way, I'd like to thank Karen for giving me 2 lovely daughters. I'd like to thank Karen even more for just giving me 2 lovely daughters. We had Amy's wedding last year and Rachel's this year. I think we couldn't really cope with another one for next year. And now, much to Stuart and Kieran's disgust, we've actually formally closed the bank of Mum and Dad. Although I expect 4 too many years the bank of Grandad and Grandma. I'd like to thank Hayley, the matron of honour, and all the bridesmaids for supporting Rachel. You all look absolutely beautiful today. And I'd like to thank Connor and James, the best man and groomsmen, for supporting Stuart Day. You all looked okay. Ish. And finally, I'd like to thank the staff here at Treehouse for looking after us this afternoon. So on the 19th of August 1992, Rachel came into my life. When I first set eyes on her, she was a mass of ginger hair, a screwed up face, uncontrollable limbs making strange noises. I fell in love with her. When I first saw Rachel, she said, "Oh, it's a baby." Don't quite know what she was expecting. So fast forward in time now to the 27th of August 2011, when Stuart first met Rachel on a night out in Old Town. She was a mass of ginger hair, a scuba face, broken toy wings, making strange noises. It was one of those extremely rare occasions that Rachel was drunk. So much so that she threw a phone at Stuart and demanded he put his number in it, as she was far too drunk to remember her own number or input his number into her phone. Stuart, ever the gentleman, did so, and then pulled Rachel into a taxi to send her home. And the rest is history. Rachel's also been very determined and stubborn as she grew up. When she decided that Stuart was the man for her, I'm afraid, Stuart, your fate was sealed. When Stuart met Rachel, he used to be a massive fan of Superman, but now he's a Disney freak as Rachel is. So much so that he proposed to her in Disney World and they go there for their honeymoon. So Stuart has become Aladdin to her Jasmine, Prince Eric to her Little Mermaid, Prince Charming to her Cinderella, and the Beast to her Beauty. Rachel's become Lois Lane to his Superman, although she may be getting rid of his Superman boxer shorts. But I'm told it looks kind of cute in his Little Mermaid ones. This has been a very special year for Rachel. She completed her degree. She got close to work, and she's married the man of her dreams. And Stuart starts his new job on Tuesday.
Monday.
So Rachel, it's been a pleasure watching you and your sister grow up. I'm pleased to say that despite the odd moments of bickering between the two of you, especially in the back of a car when we're lost, you are both very close to support each other. You know you've succeeded as parents when your kids grow up from nice people. Stuart, I know you'll take care of Rachel and look after her. And if you don't, remember, she is freakishly strong, can out wrestle most people, and her elbows really hurt. So Rachel and Stuart, I hope you're happy in your marriage, Karen and I, and Steve and Debbie have been. So between us, we've been married for 63 years. So now I've warmed up for the main acts, the groom and the best man's speech. I have one last duty. So ladies and gentlemen, please be upstanding and join me in giving a toast to Rachel and Stuart for all the very best in the future. Ladies and gentlemen, the bride and groom. Thank you.
Good time?
Yeah!
Right, I'll start off with a few jokes. Basically, I'd just like to say on behalf of me and Rachel, this is the first time I've ever been allowed to speak of Rachel and Rachel. Depending on how well this goes, it's probably going to be the last. You know, I'd just like to say a huge thank you to all of you guys for making the long journey. Obviously, it means a lot to me and Rachel to have you all here today to celebrate our wedding day. So I'd like to raise a glass to you guys for making the long journey. Thank you very much. Thank you. Then I'd just like to move on to the bridesmaids, who look absolutely fantastic today, where you all scattered around the room at Rachel. Number one. Sorry, man. There's a joke. I'll keep digging. So, bridesmaids, just like to raise a glass to you guys for helping Rachel out. I'm sure she's been amazing to but yeah, thank you for all your hard work in planning the wedding. It's made it easier for me to sit back and do nothing. So on behalf of you guys, if you'd like to raise a glass to you guys, so thank you very much. Hayley.
Oh no.
Where do I start with Hayley? Obviously, she's Rachel's sister. But I remember the first time I got introduced to Hayley and Kieran, I thought, you know, I'd go around their house, bet cool, have dinner, and then decided to fall down their stairs. And ever since then, I'm never allowed to forget it. But Hayley, I mean, you are amazing for Rachel and for everything you've done in planning the wedding and doing all your arts and craft nights, all your late nights, even helping with the honeymoon as well. We have a little token for you, so a little gift and our appreciation for Hayley. So everybody, good morning. Groomsmen, where do I start with these guys? Just like to say thanks to the groomsmen for actually getting me here on time, because I have a habit of not turning up to things on time or at all. So thank you guys very much, and the stag do was fantastic. Connor, James, Carl, Kieran, Neil. Neon was a no-show again. No, thank you very much, guys. It's been awesome, and thank you for this morning for keeping me calm and feeding me lots of drinks and biscuits. Thank you very much. Parents, mum, dad, what can I say? You've raised a fantastic son. Thank you. Again, obviously, I'm just saying thank you a lot, I know, but for over the years, for everything you've done for me, Rachel, for all your hard work, putting up with my diva moments, and Rachel's as well. We have a few tokens of our appreciation.
That's your dad.
What?
That's your dad.
Don't speak.
Thanks. So Dad, that's for you. Thank you very much. And Mum, that's for you as well.
Thank you.
Now you're married, we're going to upload the stag do video.
Darren and Neil have obviously been... Oh, you've been giving them already. Oh, well, yeah. Okay. Darren and Neil, I'd just like to say it's a pleasure to, you know, for you guys to be in my life. I think now I'm married, I might turn up to a few more Sunday roasts. Right?
Sorry, Debbie.
But no, that's it for the thank yous. Obviously, I'd like to say, well, I don't really know what to say about my beautiful bride. The bastard, she looks amazing. Doesn't she look amazing every day? Now, obviously, Rachel, I'm madly in love with you. Sorry. But you've been in... Sorry. We've been through a lot together. Obviously, with my own... I won't go too much into it with my past, but obviously living with you, putting up with all your alarms, to wake up in the morning. I can't imagine my life without you. I'm not very good at talking about feelings and things, so I'll keep this short and sweet. So I'd just like to say how much I love you, and I can't wait to spend the rest of my life with you. So that's enough of me. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to pass over to my best man Connor, if he's ready, if he's even written anything down.
Sorry about the seats.
Thank you guys, everybody. Connor.
Connor, I've had to put up with Stuart my whole life. First of all, I'd like to thank James for giving me the opportunity to talk about Stuart fully. I've got a few special thank yous to give out. First of all, it's to Hayley and Karen. How they put up with all of us men dressing us with the outfits, no man knew his size, alterations. They had plenty to think about, and all they thought about was us. Round of applause for them, please. My next thank you's for Debbie, Stuart's mum. She waited on us hand and foot at the stag do. I mean, she should have just let us go, be men, get on with it. But no, she promoted us food, drink, whatever we wanted. She was travelling out to us every single day. And she deserves a round of applause for that. I know I'm rushing, but I'm a bit nervous. So. The next one, finally, let's talk about Stuart and Rachel. First, Stuart. The kid had no luck growing up. No, honestly. He goes on about being a great sportsman, football, whatever. Shut up. Honestly. Don't listen to what he said. But his luck changed massively when he met Rachel. I never thought I'd see a woman like that be accepting a man like him. just speak for the kind of woman she is. Try to be sincere. Rachel, I haven't got to know you greatly, but I'm willing to share my best friend with you, and after tonight, I realise how much they want to get married to each other. If anyone saw the service, which you all did, how they read their vows so fast was unbelievable. They just wanted it done. So, finally, I know this is short and sweet, but it's all I have to say because they're perfect. I love them. Could you all raise a glass to Stuart and Rachel, my best friend and his best friend?
In your eyes. I think I wanna marry you. Is it the look in your eyes, or is it this dancing juice? Who cares, baby? I think I wanna marry you. Everybody gets high sometimes, you know. What else can we do when we're feeling low? So take a deep breath and let it go. You shouldn't be drowning on your own. And if you feel you're sinking, I will jump right over into cold, cold water for you. And although time may take us into different places, I will still be patient with you.
If you'd like to all head out when you're ready, go into the potted shed for the disco. Thank you very much, guys.
Different places, I will still be patient with you. And I hope you know.
A million dreams, it's all it's gonna take. there's a house we can build. Every room inside is filled with things from far away. The special things I can buy you, each one there to make you smile on a rainy day. They can say it all sounds crazy. They can say we've lost our minds. Well, I don't care if they call us crazy. Run away to a world that we design.
Drop down my ball.
My ball.
How do you drinking my hand, steady looking at me, still asking questions. Time's up, nigga, pass me another contestant. Whole move to the left if you ain't about 50. I talked through 3 or 4 songs already. Looking at a nigga with your palm out. Bitch, I ain't even seen you dance. Twerk something, baby. Work something, baby. Poppin' pussy on the pole, do your thing, baby. Slide down that bitch a little bit, then stop. Get back on the floor, catch your balance, then drop. Now bring it back up, clap your ass like hands. I just wanna see your ass dirty dance. Yin yang, we done done it again. And put it on the map like, hey.
369, damn, baby. Hey.
Let's take shots.
If you're feeling drunk, put your hands.
hands in the air. And if you're trying to fuck, put your hands in the air. Now say I'm fucked up. I'm fucked up. I'm trying to fuck. I'm trying to fuck.
Shots, Patrons on the rocks, and I'm ready for some shots. The women come around every time I'm pouring shots. Their panties hit the ground every time I give them shots. So cuffs in the air, everybody, let's take shots.
I'm fucked up.
Let's go!
Shoulder to cry.